We've got skyrocketing inflation, high diesel fuel, and Democrats' America Last policies. Democrats aren't the only one destroying farmers' ability to put food on the table. We've got wild hogs destroying farmers' fields. So we decided to go hog hunting. American farmers out. Sign up below and let's go in that helicopter and go hog hunting. Enter to win now.
Okay, there's a lot going on there. Let's start off with this. First of all, I have a challenge. Marjorie Greene, I would like to direct this to you directly. I challenge you to do one literal day of actual work in your life. You are a congresswoman. Go write legislation. Go meet with a constituent. Talk to an activist. Act like you care about being in Congress for one day, not a long day, 8 hours. I think that's reasonable. Clock in, clock out 8 hours later, and have actually done your job as an elected representative for 8 hours. That's my challenge to you. There is no way you'll be able to do that. Second of all, and obviously more importantly, that's just an allusion to murdering Democrats. That's all that is. We're not playing games where we pretend that she's not sure about it. She said Democrats are stopping you from putting food on the table. You know what else are? Hogs. Let's kill them. So Jayar, I know that you talked about this morning, but that's all this is. We can't shoot the Democrats, I guess. So let's shoot the hogs, which are stand-ins.
I actually didn't notice that comparison. I did point out
they said. She directly went from they're stopping you from putting food on the table. So are hogs. Let's shoot them.
I totally see it, by the way. I thought it was hey, I want to do this hog hunting thing. This is fun because I've, again, as you point out, she's got nothing to do or she has no interest in doing anything. And some person from a company that runs this hog hunting expeditions said, hey, Congressman Greene, would you like to come out and shoot some hogs with us? It's like, yeah, let's parlay this into an ad where, again, this contest leads to people donating more money. It can be triple fold. It can be about the money. It can be about her expedition and also about telling people, hey, shoot those Democrats because we know you're locked and loaded and ready. In fact, come hang out with me and shoot some hogs.
Yeah.
By the way, that point in the video when she's hanging out the helicopter and she's shooting at the hog and then there's some cartoonish sound of at the bottom of it, right when she shot. I'm gonna go 95%. She never shot that gun, that she never shot a hog, that a hog never died on that entire trip that she was on in that helicopter. It was all a fake badassery move where she thinks now people are gonna think they can hang out with me and shoot hogs. By the way, my producer signed up and it led to a donation page.
Of course.
Now let's talk about some other things that happened with the Green New Deal. I mean, this is going to be a future we're looking at where many bird species begin to go extinct. You want to know why? Because of all the wind turbines that are being littered across America. You guys have plenty of them here in Texas. That didn't work out so well in the last ice storm, did it? No.
Okay, there's a lot of misinformation there. First of all, no, it did not fail at outsized rates compared to the non-renewable energy, which she knows failed. She knows that Texas did nothing to weatherize it and is not going to, no matter how many times it fails. So that's just a fun little bit of misinformation and demonizing renewable energy. But we'll focus on the birds because this is something I would consider it one of the hits for Donald Trump to talk about the windmills killing all of the birds. And I've never really believed that he believed it. I think that he's opposed to it because he thinks he's supposed to be. Conservatives are supposed to hate renewable energy for some reason that makes no sense to me. But I think I can almost believe that she thinks that these are just massive chainsaws slicing through bird populations around the country. There are a million things that kill birds. Windmills are never going to be a significant part of that, even if we, as we need to, get 10, 100, 1,000 times as much capacity as we have right now. But this sort of thing seems to work, Francesca. She throws out a dumb thing like that, a piece of misinformation, half remembered and poorly explained. And it will get a bunch of people there who might benefit, their communities might benefit from renewable energy to think, yeah, we shouldn't have that because birds or something.
Yeah, I love the right when it comes to climate change. Just like, you know, the windmills kill all these birds. Anyway, let's keep on choking this pelican with oil. Help me. You get its legs and you're just like, they do not care. And it's amazing to me because, again, if we were the ones concerned about birds, like if we were talking about oil spills and we're talking about birds, they'd be like, oh, you little snowflake, you little precious little bro, you and your little precious little bird friends, you know? 100%. Obviously, birds are big leftists. We know this ever since that bird landed on Bernie Sanders' podium like an act of God, and we still decided to not make him president. Anyway, I digress.
I know. We ignored what Gaia was telling us.